All right, welcome to the Moderate Core program. I want to put you through this. Now, who exactly is this for? This is not for beginners. It's also not for people who are injured, okay? You have to have done some basic core work before you get to this one. I suggest you're shown by a pro, whether it's a chiro, a physio, a personal trainer, a kinesiologist, an athletic therapist. Just have somebody walk you through this. It's safer. First one, and these guys are, check out Optimum Wealth if you can. They got great YouTube content. This is a straight Swiss ball back extension. You can see the feet are on the wall. He's draped over the ball, belly button on the North Pole, and then he's just going to straighten up. Don't extend all the way back. Just go to a straight line between the knees and the shoulders, and you're going to feel that contraction in the low back. You'll have to do lots of reps for this. Don't grab any weights. Just use your body weight. This hits the posterior chains. There's two sets of posterior chain muscles. These are not individual muscles. This is the line of stress that goes through sets of muscles. It's a muscle chain. That's why it's called the posterior chain. And you're seeing there's lats involvement, glutes and outer quads, outer hamstrings, sorry, and the full belly hamstring. It mainly focuses on this area, which supports the lumbar spine, which is one of the reasons I have you guys do it. This is from the Howcast folks. Again, go look up their YouTube content. And this is a straight pike on the ball. So you get in a push-up position, put your feet on the ball, put both feet on the ball, get positioned and balanced, and then she's going to roll the ball towards her arms by piking, driving the hips towards the ceiling. Ready, set, go. Here she goes. So here comes the pike. You want to hold it for 3 to 5 seconds. That's the hard part. You'll feel this throughout your whole body, upper body as well. Go back down, and then you pump it right back up again. You're going for 3 to 5 seconds hold at the very top. It's a great anterior chain exercise. Now, this is what the anterior chain looks like. Let me just get to the next slide. Again, these are not muscles. These are muscle stress lines of drive, okay? And I like the crisscrossing fashion. There's some muscles being left out in here, like there's some pec and shoulder stability work. You see the serratus anterior is involved because the shoulder blades have to be stabilized when you're doing that movement. And it crisscrosses through the rectus and transverse abdominis, as well as some of the oblique lines. Hip flexors are involved. Wonderful exercise. This is one of my absolute favorites. It's called the 90-90 Copenhagen side plank. It's called 90-90 because both knees are at 90 degrees, there and there. This one's not touching anything, it's free floating. And you gotta form a straight line from the shoulder to the knees. This is Michael Robinson. Please check out his YouTube stuff. He's got some really, really good stuff. This is a wonderful lateral chain one, and I'll show you why. It strengthens throwing athletes, and including athletes who punch, because you're throwing your fist when you're doing a power punch. It hits the inner thighs, which people usually never train, as well as the opposite-sided QL. It has a crisscrossing stability function, which is fantastic for sports. This is the finisher. It's a straight-up hamstring roll. The Vivo 360. Guys, check them out on YouTube. Get on your back, hands on the ground, pelvis off the ground the whole time. You're just rolling the ball in and out, just like that. Looks easy. It's not that easy. If you want to progress it, you put your hands and you clasp them in front of you off the ground. And there's a balance component here. It's mainly targeting the hammies right in there, but in a way that's not the same as a curl machine or straight-legged deadlifts. Very sports-specific. Now, why would you want a strong core? Well, for once, it decreases your chances of injury. So if you're a desk worker, you're at risk from sitting all day, okay? If you're a tradesman, you're at risk for bending over. The stronger your core, the more advanced your core routine, the less chance of injury you have. Plus, if you're a hobby horse athlete or even a more serious athlete, you want to up your performance, just do your core training, take it to the next notch, you will improve in one way or another. So if you want to come in and have something customized for you, just hit us up, drparenteau.youcanbook.me. Come on in, we'll get you suited up. Thank you so much.